This is The Rundown. I'm Hari Srinivasan. It's been about a year since the worst environmental catastrophe in U.S. history. And we're talking, of course, about the Deepwater Horizon spill and the Gulf oil spill that came from it. We're joined by Shauna Sanford and Charlie Winham of Louisiana Public Broadcasting. They've been there for the past year. They've been covering several stories on this, and they join us now from the studios. Thanks for being with us.
It's a pleasure to be with you, Hari.
Thanks, Hari.
All right, so let's talk a little bit about a couple of the big picture stories that you've been focused on for this one-year anniversary special. Shauna, let's start with you. There's so much concern about how people are being recompensated, whether they're able to get back to their normal lives, and how the money is trickling down into that region. What's happening?
It's a mixed bag. I got a chance to spend some time with a gentleman, Preston Dore, who's been a commercial fisherman for the last 30 years. He was one of the lead vessels in the Vessel of Opportunity program. He said when they got the call, he was actually in the middle of shrimping. He was looking for 2010 to be a comeback year after struggling after Hurricanes Katrina and Rita. Got the call from BP to go out, and he didn't hesitate. He worked with several other vessels, and during that time, he suffered a lot. His boat, as he described it, the shrimping boat was really not designed for the kind of work that they were doing, but they were going to the aid of their country, he said. They were going to the aid of the Gulf. They were fighting to save the coast. They were fighting to save their industry. So they were doing everything that they possibly could to capture the oil, to stop the oil, and to get back to business as usual. Well, since that time, he's had a very, very difficult time. He has been unable to put his boat back out in the water. He fears the contamination from the chemicals that were used, and so he's not able to put that boat back out there, and as a result, he's financially in a big, big bind. Now, there have been some fishermen who have filed their claims, who have settled, they've been compensated, but then there are many, many others who have not been compensated.
Charlie, you had an opportunity to focus in on a specific community, the Vietnamese fishermen that are out there. How are they reacting?
As Shauna just mentioned, the confusion is already there for folks who can communicate in English. So you have the complicated situation multiplied tenfold with the native language being Vietnamese for the fishing communities down in South Louisiana. There's over 13,000 boats that are run or owned by Vietnamese Americans in the Gulf Coast. So their biggest confusion is first just finding somebody to translate this complicated process. We followed them throughout this past year, and I talked just most recently at the one Vietnamese community center down in South Louisiana in New Orleans East. And there's basically, you know, a handful of people who are attempting to help thousands of people try to get the claims process put together. First it was with BP, then it was with Ken Feinberg. And actually, some of the folks in the community center said, we think the folks with BP were doing a better job. At least they responded quicker than the Ken Feinberg folks.
Louisiana Public Broadcasting is part of a larger public media exchange in how we've been covering this spill. There are, of course, the spill went across state lines throughout the entire region, and the public media is spread out across that region too. How has the public media exchange been covering this?
Well, it really has been fantastic. What we're doing is pulling stories from our various areas and putting all of those stories together to sort of give a wide range view of exactly how far-reaching the impact really is, even now, a year later.
Charlie, also going forward, what's the plan? I mean, I know that there's a lot of national media or commercial media attention that'll come back in for the one-year anniversary, but this is your neighborhood. How do you continue covering it?
Element, I think, as we move forward is what is the REACH research saying? Where do we go from here? Because that data is still coming in. Mm-hmm. There's folks with NOAA, with folks trying to get samples, as well as other government agencies, all doing basically their separate research studies to try and capture any idea, any patterns of what exactly is this oil possibly having an effect on people. So really the next big issues are the research, where does it take us, and then it just falls into the litigation process.
I also got a chance to talk with an attorney who is not looking just at the economic losses, but he's focusing on those people who are suffering, who are having health problems. And there are many health problems. People have gone on record saying that they're suffering now from various health issues that they were not suffering with before. And we're talking about people who were involved in the Vessel of Opportunity program. There's a big study underway at LSU that's looking at thousands of people who were involved in the cleanup, who live close to the area where the oil spill, where the oil was coming in, to see what some of the long-term health effects are going to be. So the stories are going to continue.
All right. Shauna Sanford and Charlie Winham, thanks so much for staying on those stories. Thanks for joining us today.
Thank you.
Thanks, Hari.
This is The Rundown. I'm Hari Srinivasan. Stay with us.